Welcome to the lab.
Turn down our EQX here, listen to every day after George leaves.
Okay. So you wanted to see what I do. So right now I'm cross-sectioning all these boards. There was a board that was about this size, maybe from here to here. And it had about, I forget, it was 20 or 25 tiles. And each one of these represents a tile. They're labeled, and then we have other labeling. But basically, I've had to make a few cuts. There's a diamond saw over here, basically a copper blade, and it's got diamond impregnated in it to cut through these circuit boards, which is what they are. Probably hard to get a close-up here, but, you know, there's, I forget, 28 layers in this thing? A lot of layers. It's pretty thick. Kind of heavy for a circuit board. And I've got these holes here. Autofocus on this is awesome. But anyway, there are a bunch of holes drilled into these boards. What I've got to do is I've got a saw, and yeah, it's hard to see the detail there, but the areas where it's whiter, that's where those holes are. And I've got a saw approximately halfway through and grind out the rest on the polisher. So I take, I don't know if I've got some loose ones over here. So this is another area of the lab here. And you take the smaller section off that, and here again, you can see some more contrast in here, those white areas. So this is a rougher grit right here, more coarse, and I take it and I grind it, throw it on. This is a polishing station right here. So we got two of these things. That one over there is for the fine polishing. So we do these two steps. So I take this and sand. And once I've got halfway through, then we take that, and I actually have to saw this in half again on the diamond saw that was over there. And then after that, I bring back the little chips, and I make them into little molds. And there's two ingredients for the acrylic we use. It's a powder and a liquid. And started using these molds and doing them one at a time. And 720 samples, that really takes forever. So we've been going to, well, actually just this week, I've been working on, like I told you the other day, a method to group them. And here you can see five in there at once. So each board has 12 samples. So there's 5, 5, 2 is how we're handling it, I guess. So 3 samples per each board, and then 5 or 10 samples. 10 boards altogether per material type is, that's 30 instead of 60, or no, 120. It was 120 per material before, so. Yeah, a lot of work here. So, mix them up in these little cups right here. I've got, they're disposable. And you pour the polymer in while it's still not as viscous, and then it sets. Here I've actually got two. I've got them on glass plates because we used to be able to just, you know, use these cups and they freestand. And these actually came with little bottoms, but we needed the freedom that the glass plates allowed. Plus you can, it's actually setting. I turn it upside down right now, but I don't think it's gelled yet completely. Yeah. Okay, you saw a finished product, and these come out of those over there on top of the mini fridge. So, yep, once you take this, I'm not going to take this video recording upstairs, but there's a microscope up there, and we look at it and take a picture after that. So, basically, this is what my day consists of. There's a bunch of other neat stuff in here, but I really haven't gotten that much of an introduction to it. They need this project done as soon as possible. There are a lot of these boards. Ton of them. And then here's 3 more bags of them. And then there are 6 sets of these. This is the third one, so I think after this week we'll be halfway done with the project, but there's more coming in at the end of this month, so. If there's more to tell, I'll tell you after the video's over. Okay, I'll see you. Bye.